Do you struggle with long deployment cycles, managing multiple applications and environments, or just juggling a cloud-native toolchain that got a little bit too complex? Welcome back to Platform Engineering. We're like the bacon to your build team. Without us, there's just no sandwich. Hi, I'm Luca from the Platform Engineering community. In this video, we're going to explore the wide world of internal developer platforms, or IDPs for short. We'll define what an IDP is, why you might need one, and how to get started on your platform journey today. All right, so what is an IDP? Well, an internal developer platform is a set of tools and technologies that a platform engineering team binds into a golden path to enable developers self-service along the entire lifecycle of an application. By providing developers with self-service option while driving standardization, IDPs significantly boost productivity through a reduction in waiting time, destruction, or just manual work for operation teams. A recent benchmarking study we did on platform engineering has shown that IDPs are the single biggest driver to help an organization innovate faster and slash time to market. There is no one-size-fits-all for IDPs. The platform at a large retailer in the States will differ widely from the platform at a startup in Berlin. But there are still clear patterns in the design of modern IDPs, and they can be divided and described by five planes. The exact designs of those planes differs by organizational preference. First, we have the developer control plane, which clusters the primary interfaces developers can choose to use when interacting with the platform. Such an interface could be a workload specification for a fully code-based interaction, a developer portal for a UI-based view, or an API and CLI. The integration and delivery plane contains the flow of a request from the interface all the way through to the running application with all its configured resources. It includes CI pipelines, a platform orchestrator, maybe a dedicated CD system, and sometimes dedicated infrastructure control planes. The resource plane encompasses all cloud and on-prem resources. This includes compute, databases, file storage, or DNS. The security plane includes policy layers and secrets management, and the observability plane, logging and APM functionality. If you're a developer developing your application with a state-of-the-art internal developer platform, you should be able to self-serve everything you need to build, deploy, and operate your application and resources. It's important to point out that this goes way beyond the creation phase of a service. Well-crafted platforms treat every single deployment like day zero and create application and infrastructure configurations dynamically with every Git push. This ensures consistency and standardization across the entire lifecycle of your application. Well-designed IDPs follow a platform-as-a-product approach, where a platform team builds, maintains, and continuously improves the IDP using product management principles and best practices. So why would you need an IDP in the first place? Most organizations already have an IDP, actually, whether they realize it or not. The question is whether it's a scalable, enterprise-grade IDP. A modern IDP ensures standardization by design, enables developer self-service, and reduces cognitive load on developers. It can help organizations innovate faster, shorten time to market, increase revenue growth, and improve customer satisfaction and retention. So how do you successfully build an IDP? Well, like most things in life, it starts with listening. Listen to your developers, understand what the current bottlenecks in the delivery workflows are, and find the minimum common denominator issues to address first. When it comes to an architecture, there are several ways to build an IDP. A great starting point is your CI/CD setup and following in everything as code policy to ensure consistency in how your configurations are managed across different teams. Implementing a platform orchestrator to then generate application and infrastructure configurations dynamically is key to ensure a modern IDP design. Thank you for watching this video on internal developer platforms. I really hope it provided you with everything you need to know on what an IDP is, how it works, and the benefits it can offer to your team. And if you have any questions or comments about IDPs or other platform engineering concepts, please leave them in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button and ring the notification bell to never miss a video. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next one.